Oh yes, it's Grand Theft Auto 5 for the PC. People have been waiting for this one for more than a year. This game has everything, a gigantic world to explore and fool around with, so many vehicles and guns and people, and some monster PC requirements. No, seriously, look at this thing, it takes 65GB just to install the game. There's not a single element here that is not alarming. I can hear my computer crying just looking at this. But hey, when has that stopped us? This is the LowSpecGamer, where Grand Theft Auto 5 looks like Grand Theft Auto 3, and everything over 20 is considered playable framerate. So forget about population density and glass reflections, because we are going to make this game run.
If that's our standard for goodness, no wonder this country's screwed.
Okay, I wanted to show you this ominous message I am shown when I try to start the game. Oh yes, this is going to be fun. This is the default configuration the game opened up with. Now, this is the game's default minimum preset with two very important things that I have changed. The first one is the resolution. Originally, the game launched in the smallest resolution possible, 800 by 600 pixels. I took it up to 720 since my external game capture was not playing well with the resolution, but you can use the smallest one if you like to increase your performance. There is no shame in playing on low resolutions, not here. The other one is that vertical sync was originally in half mode and I turned it off. There is a very good reason for this and I will explain later in the video, so stick with me. Now, let's see how it plays. There is an entire world out there to f*** with, let's go! This truck is not the best for the city. Luckily for me, I like that car over there. Congratulations, this car is now mine. This car is really fast, my computer is not. 15 frames per second is too slow to play, even for me. Time to reduce the settings. First, set DirectX to 10. I have run benchmarks for the three possible options and so far DirectX 10 seems to come out on top. The difference between 10 and 10.1 seems to be very small, but I'm going to go for 10 just to be safe. For most options, the lowest you can go is normal, which is a very interesting way of avoiding the word low. And the only other thing we can tone down is reflections to normal. Let's see if there's any difference. Time to go! Off the start, we're seeing 45 frames per second. The most I saw last time was 30 something, so there's definitely an improvement. This feels better, but I want to take this run to the north of Los Santos, where things usually slow down. Stop! There's the car I like again. I am taking it. What is wrong with this guy? Stop it, you're slowing my computer down. Oh, clearly that action got my performance down. And now that I'm being chased, the game sinks to a new lower frame rate. I do not like my chances. Time for my first tweak. First thing we're going to do is to turn off auto-scan for music in your audio menu. Seems like something very simple, but the auto-scan function is searching for music in the background as you drive, and my CPU is very slow as it is. Now, there's a couple of settings on the game that we can disable using the settings file. This file is located in your document folder, Rockstar Game, GTA 5. Open this file with Notepad. This is what we're going to do. Set shadow quality to 0. This will disable most of the game's shadows altogether. Then, just to be sure, I'm going to disable shadows in particles, then disable blur in reflections, and fog volumes. Now we have truly disabled all effects and shadows. Be sure to save your file before you leave. Now you realize just how many shadows this game has, this looks odd now. Well, time to hit the street. Whoops! I intended to do that. The performance is better. Disabling reflections has some really odd effects on water. Check out how strange this looks. Well, it's playable. 50-something frames is not bad, that is a new high. Game has not slowed down so far, let's look for those slow areas. Out of my way, people. I am looking for things to make my computer slow. Whoa, okay. It's not 12, still playable, but there are definitely heavier areas. Not bad, though. Let's make our own road and piss everyone off. This is not bad, it keeps itself over 20, but this game is the ultimate mess with everything sandbox and I want to steal a plane and fly around. What a great opportunity to show you my last tweak. Search for Notepad and click to open, because we are going to write a little script. You're going to write or copy this, I'm going to leave this text in the description. So what does this do? Well, if you have been a low-spec gamer for some time, you have probably come across process priorities and probably have experimented with them. They are a common source of speculation when trying to push the boundaries of CPU usage. This script launches GTA 5 from Steam using the ID and then proceeds to set the GTA 5 process to the highest priority and the processes associated with the launcher to idle in order for them not to take any more CPU time. The logic is that high priority processes get more CPU time and therefore run faster. In most games, the effect is usually underwhelming, but this time I was caught a little off guard of how well this works. And I suspect it has more to do with how much CPU the launcher is actually using. Anyway, save this, not as a text file, to your desktop as launchergta.bat or some name you may remember. It has to be a .bat file though. And now, every time you want to play, all you need to do is to click this script. Wait, I want that bike. Woohoo! We're going to the airport at an outstanding almost 55 frames per second. Yeah, almost there. Wait, the airport is down there, I need to go down. Problem solved. Now I need to find something to enter the airport and clear a path, I am ramming my way in. Or not. Thank you, gate. Now, where can I get a small plane? There is one. Out of the way, I'm trying to get this plane to work. Turn, damn it, turn! Haha, catch me now! Yep. Right, second attempt. Look, there is a plane right there this time. Time to fly. So long, fools. Catch me now. Well, the plane is doing fine. But before I go, I want to share one last tidbit. If I get close to the ground, you will notice how the frame rate drops. As it is right now, the frame rate dances between 20 and 60, depending on what you're doing. If you go into options and change your vertical sync to half, something really interesting happens. The game will cap your frame rate to half of your monitor's sync rate. I have a 60Hz monitor, which means my frame rate gets capped at 30. Now, this can be very good if you're getting an unstable frame rate. You will not get the amazing numbers we have seen in certain areas, but the drops will not be quite as dramatic, so it evens out. If you are experiencing dramatic drops from time to time, give this a go. I'm going to try and push things a little bit and show you how the frame rate remains stable. Let's get the world spinning a little bit. Okay, too low. Oh shit, tree, tree, tree! That was close. Whoops. I wonder if I can land in some random place. Ha! Nailed it. Oh well.